oxygen, you breathe it again. See how that works? You have the oxygen cycle, the things around us where the trees give us oxygen, and we breathe off carbon dioxide. You see that cycle? That's an ongoing cycle. If we didn't have that, we wouldn't be here. Now you also think of the cycle where the water up and down evaporates, comes into a cloud, it rains. Where would we be without water? These are called providence miracles, miracles that we don't even think about, that happens every single day, that keeps us alive. And we take it for granted. Sustaining miracles every single day. Transcendent miracles, where God chooses to work within the world itself, like the earthquake, as I mentioned. And then the transcendent miracles, where God steps out of the laws of nature and performs those miracles that we are allowed to see. There you go. Any questions on the three miracles? Now, scientific theories and creation. I'm going to show you a very brief video about what science says about creation, and I'm going to connect that with the miracles. Everything, Venus and Mars, is too hot. The only planet in the universe, the solar system, that is in the perfect position, in the perfect position to create life. Do you think that's by chance?
No. Yeah.
Cold gas giants. But not so close that its surface is exposed to extreme heat and solar radiation, as is the case with Mercury. Earth's unique position in the solar system allows it to house phenomena yet to be found anywhere else in the universe, particularly liquid surface water and life. According to one theory, much of Earth's water is as old as its rocks, both of which have been formed during the Earth's earliest days. Because of Earth's unique distance from the Sun, the planet is able to contain water in all of its forms, liquid, ice, and gas, rather than have them permanently frozen or evaporated into space. But Earth is the only known place in the universe with liquid water on the surface, thereby having unique cascading effects on the planet. It hydrates the land, helping create nutrient-rich soil. It collects and cools to form oceans and freshwater systems, and it cycles upward to add moisture to Earth's protective atmosphere. And where there is liquid water, there is life. About 3.8 billion years ago in Earth's oceans, primitive life life existed in the form of microbial organisms. They, and then through millions of years, give rise to a range of more advanced life forms that thrive in Earth's seas, lands, and skies. As the only world known to harbor life, Earth's biodiversity is expansive in nature. An estimated 1.5 million species of plants, animals, bacteria, fungi, and others have been cataloged, with potentially millions, if not billions more, yet to be discovered. Home to life and fueled by water, Earth houses a unique global ecosystem, as curious and as grand as the astronomical events that make them possible.
I don't believe anything's left to chance.
Right.
I believe everything has happened around us perfect in perfect pattern to give us the world that we have.
By design.
By design. Okay. Doris, got your point here? No.
Which?
I need you to move that off the next screen.
Well, you didn't finish the video.
Oh, there we did. This is all.
That's all you want.
All we did.
Okay.
And by that, I don't need another credit.
Okay. Right. Now you should be able to get
it. Okay. Now, how many of you ever heard of the Big Bang Theory? How many of you think it's just a bunch of hooky? Not true? Dorsey, get back over there. Sorry, Dr. Miller. Just show my best side there. Okay. How many of you believe in the Big Bang Theory? How many
know it? The Big Bang, God created it.
Well, this is what it is. Basically, the well-known theory, Big Bang Theory, talks about how a piece of energy all of a sudden it just began to expand. Now, it didn't explode. I found this out, it didn't explode. It just expands like a spring in all the different directions. And this is how the universe became, according to the theory. Now, here's the thing, though, y'all. Many Christians would argue that this is not true. That they think that's just a theory created by people that had nothing else to do but create these so-called theories in science. But the Big Bang Theory has four components, okay? Number one, that creation had a beginning. Creation had a beginning. Two, that the universe was constantly expanding away from one another. Three, that the earth is cooling off and is slowly decaying. And four, that the earth will have an ending. Those are the four elements of the Big Bang Theory. Your thoughts?
Yes, because the Bible says we'll have a new heaven and a new earth.
I want to take these to the next level, okay? Hold on to your hats. The universe had a beginning. First theory, Big Bang, Genesis 1:1. The universe is constantly expanding. Read Job 9:8. It states that the earth is gradually cooling to decay. Now, Romans 8:21 calls it corruption, but it means decay. Four, the earth will have an end. 2 Peter 3:10. Doris, cut the lights on. Let's check them off. Look up those passages. Genesis 1:1. That's easy. Job 9:8.
How do you get the Big Bang out of verse 1? In the beginning, God created the earth.
We don't know how he created it.
Theories, Charles, just theories.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but the thing about what it's saying here, even the theory says that every creation had a beginning. Everything has to have a beginning. And this is what Genesis 1:1 tells us. In the beginning. stretch the heavens out. Now, I'm going to show you some other scripture passages here in a few minutes, y'all. Some of this stuff is not going to jump out at you. It's woven within the fabric of the narrative. You've got to look for it. So don't expect these things just to jump out at you, okay? Now, this one did, because it talked about expanding. What did Peter say? Or Job say?
He stretched out the heavens. And then it goes on to say he made the Bear, the Orion, those things that we see in the sky, and the stars, and things like that.
Okay. The Big Bang Theory says the Earth is gradually cooling. Romans 8:21. Who wanted to read that one? Okay,
before you ask, is the creation itself will be set free from its bondage to corruption and obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God.
Corruption means to decay. Another term for that. It means to decay. And the last one, the earth will end. 2 Peter 3:10. Is there a connection between the theory and science and the scriptures? Well, this is the point I'm trying to bring out here. There's not any difference. If you go, let me just share this with you in a few minutes. I'm going to show you something else here. There are over 1,000 references in the Bible to creation. And it's all throughout the scriptures. Over 1,000 references to God's creation, and it's woven throughout all the books of the Bible, the 27th in the New Testament, and 39 in the Old Testament. I never looked at it from that perspective before, and I began to see, when I began taking this class, things just kind of all fit together, that there's no conflict between science and God's creation. Let me get the light real quick. Now, these are some of your main